Cool. So these are the topics which I want to cover today. Basically, that's spread out into four different topics. One is how AI is changing the future of digital marketing. Second is within AI and digital marketing, I'm picking up two different channels or two different digital mediums. One is the role of AI in universal app campaign. It's nothing called UAC, which is a Google product campaign. Secondly, the role of AI in programmatic advertising, end this session with why is it important for marketers or advertisers to understand the role of AI in digital marketing in this modern world. So these are some of the topics which I'm going to cover. If any questions, any doubts, which I'll be able to answer some of your questions and answers by end of this session in the last 10 to 15 minutes. So keep post your questions. I'll go through it and definitely give you an answer to it. But the first 45 minutes will be basically taking you through all these topics. Moving ahead from here, the first thing, how AI is changing the future of digital marketing. Now, so I'll talk about some of the facts and stats. Basically, artificial intelligence is is some of the buzzword that we hear and we talk about everywhere where we go. So artificial intelligence and machine learning are going to disrupt the traditional marketing.
Google, that's nice to interrupting you. So sure. I think few students are still having an issue in hearing the audios. Guys, I'm just repeating again, people who have joined through phone, please request you to check in your WebEx app, there is an option called voice over internet. So you have to enable, you have to click that voice over internet options, then only the audio will be able to hear it for you guys. I'm just again repeating, people who have joined through phone, I request you to choose an option called voice over internet to hear the audio. I can see a lot of chats are coming, they are not able to hear, but we are able to hear, other people are able to hear. So I request you to choose that option so that you will be connected to the session. Thank you.
Totally. At the same time, I'm, Mahesh, I'm getting a lot of annotation requests and I'm keep declining and I hope that is okay.
Yes, please.
Yeah, awesome. Cool. So I'm just continuing with the presentation. So basically, artificial intelligence and machine learning are going to disrupt the traditional marketing. What does it mean basically is, this basically means that modern marketing is completely driven by computers and programs. And it not more going to be at the way of the way of doing marketing in a traditional way. Some stats is basically if you look at 50% of the work activities could potentially be automated by today's technologies, and 80% of that is enabled by machine learning. So that's basically the power of machine learning. If you can think of 80% of the or 50% of the work activities are currently doing, be it anything that it's just not related to marketing, be anything in this country or in the world which activities are, this is potentially can be automated by today's technologies, and that's where the power of machine learning and AI comes in. I'll now talk about what AI and ML is used across these industries, across countries, but I'm specifically coming to marketing. I've picked up four different use cases or usage of AI. So what are marketers using AI for? Some of them which came in top of my mind, which are customer acquisitions and retention. Customer acquisitions and retention for any business, acquiring customers are and retaining them are the core of their existence, right? And in this competitive world, going with the traditional way isn't enough. So brand uses various machine learning algorithms to find their potential customer out there and predict their behavior to target them online using AI and ML. Likewise, for retaining the customers as well, the brand becomes customer centric approach. They understand the customer past behavior, what did they purchase in the past, what do they want, what kind of behavior they are displayed, and come up. They understand all of this using this machine learning algorithms, computer programs, etc. And there's a lot of modern companies or e-commerce or even some of the old FMCGs, they use a lot of machine learning and algorithms to understand what their customers do and what is the potential customers doing outside of the world, and understand them and then reach out to the right audience and convert them. So the traditional way of doing the marketing may not really help them in acquiring a customer, retaining them. They need to be really a data-driven approach. A lot of algorithms, machines need to be used to understand and convert these users. So some of the use cases, like one is another one is intelligence discounting, for example. These days we get notifications, we get emails, SMS, a lot of communication from a lot of brands, and a lot of discounts have been pumped up to our mobile messages. How does it happen? Basically, and at the back of it, the brands use a lot of intelligence to be handed to understand who is the user, what do they want, what are the likely, what kind of discounts they want to convert or to transact next time. It's not the same offer that comes to everybody. It's a different offer. Every offer is different for everyone. How does it work? It's basically they use a lot of data, and that data, that huge data mines into a, goes into a system, and system tries and do a look of, do a lot of math behind it to understand what does this user want end of the day. So basically what I'm coming from is a lot of machine learning and intelligence used behind this to come up with the right communication, the right discounts to the user. Next one is personalization. Personalization is a very broad topic which I put it here, but it covers a lot of aspects under that. It can be when you go to an e-commerce site, you see a listing which is very relevant or your way, very interesting for your way, which is very relevant for which what matters for you. For the same time, another friend of yours is going to an e-commerce site, will see something else, right? How does it work? Because these are the personalization that uses this personalization technologies that use these companies by understanding your user behavior. It looks at various browsing behaviors, listing behaviors, your multiple behaviors through online within the platform to understand what you actually looking for. What are your day? What stage in your life you are in? So it understands and processes a lot of data to understand what is your stage is currently, and it throws you the right message or throws you the right product in front of you, which makes relevant for you, right? And that it all happens, how it all happens through their other machine learning and artificial intelligence, which works at the back end. Lastly, it's not the last, there's an N number of hundreds and thousands of use cases, but just specifically to marketing and advertising. One of the widely used use cases of artificial intelligence and machine learning is the media optimization. When it comes to be it a Facebook marketing or be it a Google search marketing or be it anything, these days, earlier 10 years back, if you ask me, a lot of them are done or optimized basis human intervention. We basically sit out in a computer, just go through with each and every bit of keyword, ad copies, targeting, you change it every now and then to optimize it. Now it is not that, that's not the way it works. It's mostly driven by machines. Machines understand what does the user do in the morning, what is he doing in the afternoon, what kind of website he visits, everything. Hence, it can understand the user behavior and can optimize automatically if you give the right input. So these are some of the use cases which I can think on top of the mind, but there are hundreds and hundreds of use cases for AI and machine learning in this world. But coming to our topic, because it is mostly how AI is used in digital marketing is what today we are going to talk about. Moving to the next slide. So we talked about a lot of use cases. We talked about artificial intelligence, what are the use cases, etc. But what exactly is artificial intelligence and machine learning? So I'll just walk through your definition, but I'll also explain you what does it mean. So AI is nothing, it is the ability of a computer program or a machine to think and learn. It is also a field of study which tries to make computers smart. All your smartphones, all your smart computers, it's all machine and it works for you. It can think and learn and it act accordingly. Right? So it's similar like a human being, it works and reacts like humans. But to keep it very simple, it can be explained as simple as this. In a normal computer program, what do we do basically? We give an input to the system saying that okay, I need this is what the input is basically. I want to add 2 + 2. This is my input is give me the output. So that's how the traditional way of doing the computer programs. But with the introduction of AI and ML, what happens here is I'll take an example. First, we'll give an output to the system and ask system to work on what are the things that need to bring, correlate or what are the inputs that you need to require to build the particular framework. For example, I hope all of you know what is Facebook marketing and how does Facebook marketing work, right? In Facebook marketing, there is a feature called lookalike targeting. So in lookalike targeting, is basically nothing. We can basically target your user, target your similar audience. For what is similar audience? Similar audience are basically a similar behavior of your existing user you can find through Facebook. Now, what is happening in the packet? You are basically uploading a custom audience. The custom audience is nothing. It's an e-commerce site want to target their a lookalike of purchase users, their own purchase users. Now, what do they do? They download their purchase users from their backend CRM and they upload that into the Facebook system. What happens here? Basically, this brand is saying, this is my output, this is what my customer is. I want same similar kind of customer in my system. So basically, I'm giving an input to output to the system. This is my output, which is already got. Can you find the similar audience? So you're giving an already an output to the system, and system uses various data points, various insights to figure out who are the other users similar to these users, and then build a framework around that. So that's how the AI and ML is explained. It is not the way of traditional programs where you give a couple of inputs and give an answer. It has been completely moved to giving any output first and ask the system to work on itself. So that's how I can simply explain how AI and what is artificial intelligence and machine learning. Moving to the next slide. So how AI is powering digital marketing. So today I'll take two examples in the discussion. One is the role of artificial intelligence in universal app campaigns. Next one is role of artificial intelligence in programmatic advertising. So what is the role of AI in universal app campaigns? I don't know whether all of you know about what is universal app campaigns. Universal app campaigns are basically nothing. It's called as UAC. It's a Google product. To define it, it is like this. It is an ad campaign type that allows brands to advertise on some of the Google's largest networks. That includes search, display, YouTube, Google Play Store, some of the other channels also of the Google, using the Google Ads platform itself with a very minimal campaign setup process. So this is a newly introduced campaign type by Google, which is somewhere around a couple of years back, and it is completely automated. There's nothing that I can do on this campaign, and it hardly takes 10 minutes for an advertiser to set up this campaign. And for an advertiser, and when you have no control over a campaign, all you have to do is just set up a campaign within 10 minutes with a budget, some creatives and bits. You don't know what is happening in the backend, and you generally, we people, marketers, will wanted to have a lot of control over where their ad wants to show, what is the targeting, etc. Then that becomes sounds worrying for most of the marketers. And most of the marketers when I talk to in the beginning of when UAC first started, or even now, they feel little not control over the campaigns, they feel a little worried. Now if you understand this campaign very well, if you actually understand how does the AI works, how does the ML works, you don't have to really worry about it. Why you shouldn't worry about the limited options available on UAC optimizer campaigns? I'll walk you through why you should not be able. So UAC works completely on machine learning. So at the back, in the front end, you don't see what targeting it is, what kind of placements it's going to show, when it is going to show, what kind of optimization is done in the back end, nothing come to know. But it works completely in the back end. Every aspect of that we do through manual optimization is done back end by automatically by systems, because it understands whom do you want to target, where it has to show, where is your customer. Everything is understood by the system automatically. It integrates AI and ML into every phase of app proposal. So if it has to show in Play Store, has it to show in YouTube, or does the ad has to show it on search, system decides based on where is this user. If I show it to a user in YouTube, will it convert, or do I have to show it to user on a Google Play Store, where is convert? So system knows already basis is past behavior, and it takes an appropriate call on that, and it runs the algorithm automatically. and targeting is completely automated to help drive scale and efficiency. When we used to do a manual way of targeting, we create multiple campaigns, like 10, 15 campaigns, and understand what targeting works, what targeting doesn't work. You need to allocate budget to each campaign. And driving a scale at the times of which efficiency is going to be very difficult because at such a huge scale, it is very, very difficult for manually optimizing a campaign and understand how to, what to scale up, what to not scale up. But system can do this because it is completely automated. And you definitely can upload some of the creatives like a search ads or a display ad or a video ad. But optimization, generally what we marketers used to do is we optimize the creatives basis, what performing, you post some of the campaigns, you add more creative to it. But when it comes to UAC, you have a lot of options to upload a creative, there's a lot of options to upload creatives like 20 videos, more than 20 display creatives, and a lot of short assets that you can add it. Once you add this, what the system does is it start optimizing by itself. It look at what kind of creative, what video is working better, what videos, what display is working better, and it start optimizing by itself. You don't have to intervene anything in between. It automatically takes care of it as per the goal that you're setting it up. And automatic, as I mentioned earlier, automatic placement selection using machine learning. It decides where to show the ad, be it YouTube or Google Search or its Google Play Store or its search. Which is the placement it wants, so it decides automatically based on the user behavior. And that's not enough. This is the 3-4 points which are the most important, but it uses thousands and thousands of signals which is already captured in the backend of the Google to optimize this campaign. Something like an online behavior, time of the day, devices, age, gender, location, and many of more. So that's the power of machine learning and AI, and that is why I said you don't have to worry about running a campaign without having any control, because this is the future of digital marketing. And if you don't understand the importance of AI and machine learning in future, I think it is very difficult to bring scale and efficiency, because the manual way of doing the campaign is an old fashion and it doesn't bring scale and efficiency. Moving to the next slide. So I spoke about, I specific this concept. I spoke about why you should not worry, and these are the reasons why you should not worry. But are you still thinking about how does this understand your requirement? For example, I know most of us thinking about, okay, there's a business, it's an e-commerce, and there's a toy shop, a toy e-commerce, for example. And you basically want the parents to buy the toy because generally kids doesn't buy the toys for them. So the parents want to buy the toys. So how does this system understand whom do you want to target? Basically, the input is basically your budget, your bids, and your creative. So how does it work, basically? So I'm sure that most of you are thinking about how does it understand your requirement, and deliver the results accordingly. This is exactly why I tell marketers need to understand how AI and machine learning functions, because it is still vital that you understand the human input, because human input is as a successful. Without human input, it cannot be utilized at the max. So definitely there is a machine learning works, but as we marketers, we need to understand how this machine learning works and give them the right input to successfully utilizing the campaigns. In the case of UAC also, it works the same way. So even though the campaign uses machine learning to drive results, it needs to have the right inputs. When I say right inputs comes only with an expert experience, and it has to be an expert input. So input comes only with the right experience. So when you work in this campaign, you will know how this campaign is going to behave. If I give this input, what is that campaign going to behave? If I give another input, how does it going to behave separately? So this comes with an experience, and only an expert can put that kind of input into it. And it doesn't take a lot of time. It can easily learn by within a couple of pilots. So then now you'll be thinking, what are these inputs and why is it important? So some of the inputs which are very important, I have not covered all of the inputs, but some of the inputs are very important. I'll walk you through one by one. First thing is, pick the right goal for your campaign. So every campaign has a goal these days, okay? We say multiple, whatever the campaigns are due, we keep an objective behind it. But when it comes to an automatic campaign, goal has a lot of importance because it decides when you set up the goal, and that decides your research basically. So if you don't set your goal right, it can hamper the entire campaign performance. For example, in the case of UAC, UAC has basically two types of goals that you can select. One is either you can select an install or an in-app event. Installs are basically I want an install, so that's my objective. At the same time, there are a lot of clients, a lot of brands, they just don't want installs. They want an install plus they want us to open the app. Some of them doesn't even want this open, not only open the app, they also want someone to sign up the page. Some of them really not even want sign up, they also want a purchase need to be happen at an app, right? So it can be defined under in-app event. In-app event can be defined as sign-ups, open the app, subscription, purchase, etc. So it can be anything, right? But when you select a goal, you have to select carefully what is that goal one which you want to optimize for. If you miss to select this, or if you by mistake you select something wrong and your experiments are different, this campaign is never going to work. After this, you need to set the right KPI. Now you know you want to drive installs. So now you also know, if I get an install at this course, it makes sense for me. And if you give them and you need to communicate that to the systems correctly. For example, for me as a business, I want the systems to optimize or to get an install at 10 rupees. And I can't afford an install which is more than 10 rupees. You need to input that system, input that KPI into the system, saying that the maximum afford for the CPI that I'm willing to pay for this install is 10 rupees. If you don't put this input, or if you don't give this input to the system, the system doesn't know whom to reach out to, what kind of users to reach out to. It just spend the money. It might even give it for 10 rupees, or it might even give for 50 rupees, or it might even give for 2 rupees. But if it goes to 50 rupees, it's just gonna make your payment where it looks very bad. At the same way, CPA is nothing, it's cost per acquisition. If you are selecting a particular event called sign up for a subscription, you need to select that event and tell the system, hey, I want a particular sign up need to happen at 120 rupees, for example. So this is completely based on what your internal goals and targets are, and then you give that input to the system. But it is always flexible. It's not that you give that one input and then try and get that. You learn as you go, you keep changing it, but I'll come to why you change it, but it is always flexible, and you need to understand, you need to figure out what works, what doesn't work, and then keep changing this KPIs accordingly. But we make sure of this, goals and KPIs are very important for these campaigns to drive the results, and these are the goals which decides or which makes the backend of EVC, which is basically your machine learning on artificial intelligence, going to work in the backend to drive the results. Third one is the budget. Budget also has a huge role to play here, because it decides what to show the ad, what kind of users I can reach out to, because we have the online world is segregated into multiple type of users who are online savvy, who just uses social media, who just read a lot of content which is entertainment. Some of them just log into the online only once in a week. So there's a lot of segregation that do. So it depends on your budget also, where to show the ad, when to show the ad, how many times you need to show it, what all geographies you need to show it. It's all decides basis to your budget, KPIs and goals. And the next one is the right set of creatives. So for example, you want to drive a sign-up. Sign-up is what your end goal is, and you create a display video and you put it as saying that install now. It doesn't work because you are saying the system to drive and install now, and your CTA or the call to action or the creative says sign-up. So there is a disconnect here. System is trying to get installed, and the person who is seeing is a person who always try and install something and they see what is the app. He's seeing a sign-up. He might not be interested in doing that. So you need to align your creative to your goals as well as your KPIs. And some of the important parts to look at when it comes to creative is it should be a compelling creative with the right call to action, some of the right sizes and right formats. UAT has its own right size and right formats, because why I'm coming to this inputs are these inputs decides, and inputs let's ask, these are the inputs, basically this is the outputs, basically you're giving, these are the outputs. I want a CPI of 10 rupees and I want a purchase, and this is my budget, this is what my output is, give me the audience, give me the customer, right? So that's what you're giving it to the system. So if you give the right input to the system, it works accordingly, it kind of use, it start working, it looks into multiple data in the back end, mine the data, learn, do a various cuts of data and understand, and do a map behind it and try and reach out to the right user. The last and very important part is conversion tracking. Even if you do all of this without tracking, this campaign is not going to work. Why? Because if a sign up has to happen, the goal is to get a sign up, and your conversion track is not enabled, it doesn't know who's actually signing up in the past, and the systems use the past user behavior. For example, there are 10 conversions already happen at your site or app, and they look at who are these users and they find what are the behaviors of the users, and you try to find the similar users of that. And if you don't enable conversion tracking, this is just a waste of campaign that you do. Please always make sure conversion tracking is enabled for UAC campaigns so that the machine learning and the algorithms can perform the best. And also I'll talk about why is it important. For example, choosing the wrong type of UAC goal can make or break your campaign. As I mentioned earlier, if you choose a sign up goal and you optimize when you want an install, it will never give you, the cost per install becomes like 50 rupees if you want it in 10 rupees. So always choose the right goal. Secondly, making too many changes to budget and KPIs lead to fluctuations. So in the automated campaigns which runs by machine learning and algorithms, you need to understand if you give the right inputs, this machines need some time to process it in the packet. And if you give multiple inputs every minute or every hour or every day, it isn't going to work because it doesn't know what to optimize for. So you first figure out what are the right inputs you want to give it, and then step back, let the system figure it out whom you want. So please always make sure machine learning and algorithms works when it has enough time to process in the backend, not that it, when it keeps changing something in the front end and doesn't work in the backend because it doesn't know what to work on. Third is, not using the creative assets report will lead to a poor performance. You also need to use, it doesn't mean that when you just upload the creatives it is finished there. You also need to check what are the, because it can upload only 20, for example, only 20 videos can be uploaded to UAC, it is not more than that. Now, are these 20 videos enough for this campaign to perform? Maybe, may not be. So you need to always look at the reporting of creative assets and see if that performs or not performs. I need to keep changing and altering the creatives according to the performance. And the next thing is, never set up this campaign type without using conversion tracking, which I mentioned already. If you think that the conversion tracking is not enabled for this particular campaign type or an AdWords, then better you don't even start this campaign, because there are a lot of marketers I see, it's okay, let's start the campaign and see how does it go. It goes for a toss and it doesn't work at all. So always make sure conversion tracking is important. It needs to be enabled. If it enables, then only the machine learning works with the backend. But even if you do all of this, if you're not patient, you'll not get the results. As I said earlier, systems need time to process at the backend to understand what type of customers they have to, or what type of users they have to reach out to. And if you do keep changing it, or if you lose the patience and keep changing the budget bit, it doesn't give the performance. So these are the reasons why I say it is very important to have the inputs, and why is it important. Now that's pretty much about UAC. I hope that helps and helps you to understand what is the role of artificial intelligence and machine learning in universal app campaigns. Now we'll move to the next topic of today, which is basically called role of AI in programmatic advertising. Programmatic advertising is one of the buzzwords that we keep talking about it, and I think we heard about it. We like a lot of marketers and advertisers keep talking about it, but I still feel that a lot of them doesn't know how does it work, or there is definitely an unclarity with a lot of them, and it is a very simple thing. There is nothing complicated with it. So what is programmatic advertising? It's as simple as this: right message to the right person at the right time, and reaching out to the right user at the right time with the right message. It's just called programmatic advertising. It's just a way of using the machines to do this job. Why? And traditional way, we just do it by manually. So it can be explained in this way also. It is an automated technology driven method for buying and selling online ad space. So all of us goes through the news sites, entertainment sites like Times of India, NDTV, and a lot of stuff, a lot of display websites we go into and read the content, read the news, a lot of stuff like that. And the, for example, Times of India. Times of India is just a website is owned by Times of India. And how do I access that website? I basically have to go and talk to the Times of India guy and get that access to the their online space. But is that efficient? No. So before I come to the Times of India example, I'll take you through how does this programmatic advertising technically works. If you look at this particular image, look at from the right hand side, the brand comes first, and from the brand it goes to agency. So what is technically it works is, programmatic is nothing, it is basically called a tool sits in the middle where it can buy or it can integrate this particular, the multiple sites around the world or around the country like Times of India, NDTV, Live Mint or anything. Or be it an app, Jio, Seven, or Ghana, or anything it can be. All of these sites and apps can be integrated into one place where it has been completely integrated, and on a real-time basis, you can buy these online ad spaces through a particular tool. That is what you see here as a DSP. After brand and agency, basically a brand can be. You can take an example of a Flipkart, for example. A Flipkart worked with an agency called, for example, Mindshare from an agency. This agency works with a tool called DSP. There are multiple DSPs available in the market. A DSP is nothing, it's a demand side platform. This demand side platform integrates with multiple ad exchanges. Ad exchanges can be like an InMobi or an Apple, things like that, right? So what does these ad exchanges do? These ad exchanges work with another tool called supply side platform. Or a data management spreader. The supply side platform is nothing. It is another tool which works with a lot of these publishers. Who are the publishers? Publishers are nothing. These are the networks like Times of India, NDTV, etc. So how does it happen is, the publisher works with supply side platforms, and supply side platforms integrate with ad exchanges, and ad exchanges integrate the DSP, and brand. A brand uses this DSP tools to reach out to the end user. Now, in the traditional world, we used to buy this ad space by directly talking to the publisher. Like, for example, I'll pick up a form and speak to the Times of India guy. He's saying, I need a homepage banner for this date. Can you give me what is the rate and close the deal? So what they can do, they say they can guarantee only the impressions, and I cannot commit to the conversions because they don't know, they have no other technology used in the backend. All they can offer is just a space which there's a lot of users can see. It can be a user who's politically wanted to read a political news, it can be a user who's looking at an entertainment, anything it can be, but they can't size it out of it. And also you cannot manually work with thousands of partners at one time because it's humanly impossible. So you can only work with three partners. This is a blocker till few years back, I see literally agencies and brands work with these kind of publishers, just reach out to them and do a direct campaign, which is highly inefficient according to me, until and unless it just create an awareness. But in these days, digital is extremely attractive and everyone wants to have an ROI against it. Now when this blocker came, when modern digital marketers want a wide variety of opportunities, want to slice down the data, want to reach out of multiple sites, want to cut down their targeting into specific audience, and end of the day they want to measure every coin they have spent on the media. This thought has introduced programmatic advertising to marketers. So programmatic advertising is nothing, it enables advertisers to buy ad spaces and audience across lakhs of websites in an intelligent way. Excuse me. Now there'll be a lot of information I have spoke about. Now you'll be thinking, how does it work? How do I know where my ad is running and who is seeing which ad, which website? What is this tool about? How do I buy it through Times of India? How I buy only few banners in Times of India? How I buy few banners in other sites? How does it work? Exactly. So this is where the role of AI comes, or this is where the role of machine learning comes. It's called a DSP, Demand Side Platform. It's a tool which is available with multiple vendors. There are multiple DSPs available in this market. It's a system that allows buyers of digital advertising inventory to manage multiple ad exchanges, to make it simple, to manage multiple websites and data exchanges. To make it simple of data exchanges is nothing, it's just an audience. So managing multiple websites and its ad spaces and the audience accounts through just one interface. So there is only one interface, and using this one interface, you can reach out to the audience that you want, not the publisher offers. The audience that you want, for example, you want to reach out to users who are healthy, people who are reading a content which are healthy, and in these websites, and only the impact banners like top banners, which is your homepage banners or etc. I want to only reach out to these users. Then you can actually do that by using this particular tool by within one interface. No need to talk to 100 publishers, or no need to block time, or no need to spend a lot of money to get that. It just everything can be done by programmatically. This is where the programmatic comes. Programmatic is nothing. It's the machine learning. It's the algorithm, the artificial intelligence that work in the backend, which enables advertisers, brands like us, to go and buy this audience in one interface. This is called programmatic advertising, and this is the reason. This is the role of machine learning and AI in programmatic advertising. So it basically uses machine learning to target audience across your site. How does it work? Basically, this DSP, the demand side platform, has partnered with multiple data management platforms. These data management platforms have a lot of data about these users, about what these online behaviors, what are the sites they're visiting, what kind of content they are browsing, etc. And this DSP also has their own data, which when they work with multiple partners, and the DSP also has the data from supply side platforms and ad exchanges and publishers. So multiple inputs comes to this DSP, and this is a huge amount of data. They build their own algorithms and machines to read this data and then process that data according to what the customer, or according to that, it processes and make sure what to show, when to show to the according to the customer goal. Right? So that is how it works. Earlier it was just used to target one space without having any intelligence behind it. So that's the power and that's the beauty of programmatic advertising. What does it basically do is discussions I can talk about is predicting and planning. So it's basically the AI and machine learning have become a crucial part of the prediction and planning stage of the ad campaign. These algorithms use to analyze huge set of past data to draw insights, and it predicts who is the right person, which online site he is. Should I show him at what time should I show? All of that it predicts automatically within the microseconds. When you put a budget and when you put a bid, and if there is a particular online ad space win and auction, everything happens within microseconds to predict a user about what type of user he is. Should I show him an ad or not show him an ad? Again, within the hundreds of competition, it does this job within microseconds, and I plan it accordingly. So that's the power of AI. Thirdly, campaign optimization. They used to do the campaign optimization for working with multiple publishers, like can you post that particular inventory, can you change the ad type to this by calling up the phone, writing a mail. Doesn't work here. You need to put the right inputs, and as I mentioned earlier, keep the right budget, keep the right bids, and you just optimize the campaigns. Basically, All you have to do is go in the system and post particular site if it is not working, or negate some sites which are not working, or remove some targeting, add some targeting. Everything can be done within one interface. You don't really have to pick up a call and tell them, hey, do this, do that. So that's the power of AI when it comes to campaign optimization. At the same time, better targeting capabilities. Like I mentioned, they partner with multiple type of platforms like data management platforms, ad exchanges, publishers. There's a huge data comes in, and this huge data is processed into different buckets, and each bucket can be used. For example, if I'm a health client, I want to target only people who are eating, which I wanted to talk about. Basically, I'm a gym, a fitness company. I want to talk about people who are going to gym and talk about gym. It will have a segment within this DSP to understand who are these users, because it already know who are these users who are doing this kind of content behavior, browsing behavior, and it bucket into a particular segment called fitness. Now we can target this particular set of users. So like fitness, there are hundreds and other multiple type of targeting capabilities available. To the granular level, I can talk about, you can even target a particular mall, or as in a particular building in a particular city. That's the level of granularity a DSP can offer. Not all the DSPs definitely, but some of the top DSPs available in the market can do a job of targeting a particular mall in the city or a building in the city. That's the level of granularity it can get it. And then the moving to the next one is AI-driven creatives. Creatives, well, how do we do earlier? We just send out a creative and we track it and then say we run that the performance are not good. Next time we change it. By the time the campaign bit gets over, the budget gets over. But here, even though when you have an option to do a manual way of optimizing, there are DSPs allows you to optimize the creative or create automatic creatives from the if you give a base creative like a logo and a background or an offer, it automatically creates the creative in the backend using different API sources. For example, take an example of IPL. If I want to show a order, for example, if I want to show an order from this particular restaurant, and when somebody had a hit a six, right? And it can integrate with a particular sports API and use the signal, and the DSP can automatically create a creative according to the signal, and it shows the user at the real time saying that, hey, Virat Kohli has sent a hit a six. Why don't you order from this particular restaurant and get this offer? So that's the level of AI, artificial intelligence, machine learning. That's the power of machine learning and algorithms. At a real time, in microseconds, it happens all of this process, right? And last but not least, data-driven insight. End of the day, even when you have a lot of machine learning and algorithms work, end of the day, you need to look into the data. And the beauty of this is, you get to see a lot of data compared to the traditional way of doing marketing, where you get only impressions, clicks, etc. That's it. Now you will get to see impressions, they are the clicks definitely, but a lot of other data, which in terms of conversion, what kind of users, what time of the day, and devices, a lot of data basically. A lot of data, and use this data to plan your next set of campaigns better the way. So this is the whole role of AI when it comes to programmatic advertising, because and it's very important to understand this, because there's still a lot of brands does direct buying of the ad spaces by talking to the publishers directly. But programmatic has changed the way of buying the ad space in an intelligent way. I'll also talk about some of the best practices for training, because it is not just about AI and machine learning. You cannot get the performance just by going with it. You also have to follow some of the best practices. For example, partnering with the right platform. When I say partnering with the right platform, partner with the right DSPs. There are a lot of DSPs available. For example, Google DSPs called DoubleClick platform. There are DSPs like Smadex, MediaMath, a lot of them available in this market. But you need to understand, anybody can create a DSP, but is it a smart DSP? What are the benefits? What does it build on? They all say that it works on a predictive modeling, algorithms, machine learning. But please understand that algorithms, machine learning very well, and then choose the right platform is what my recommendation would be. And then, as I mentioned earlier, like in UAC, sending the right signals to the platform is the key. If you have to enable your conversion tracking and send the right signals and optimize for the right signals. Without this, none of these automatic campaigns will not gonna work. So signals are very important, and set your campaign goals and KPIs accordingly. Without KPIs and goals, system or algorithms what to optimize for. So always set up your campaigns as per the objectives and KPIs that you want to achieve. And you as a brand, for example, you are running a business, you have your own data about your customers, and integrate that data with the DSPs, because this data is gonna help to find the similar users by the DSPs. And if you don't give this input, it may not give the efficiency same way that we integrate. So utilize your first body data. Also, there are second and third body data where you can partner with multiple data management platforms available, which you can go and partner with them to drive more efficiency. Also, the programmatic advertising can bring strategies like audience strategies. You can do like prospecting. It has, when you give a particular input to the system, for example, a purchase data to the DSP, it can prospect to the new customers, find the new customers. It can do a behavioral targeting. It can also do a remarketing of within your audience. A lot of audience strategy, a lot of different cuts and segmentations you can do using the machine learning that performs with the backend. And last but not least, bidding strategy. It can optimize for cost per 1,000 impressions, or it can optimize for CPA or CPC, anything that you want according to your goal. So it's up to you, but you need to choose the right goal to have to get the right results. Now I'll move into the last topic of the day. I already covered it, but I want to just emphasize on this, because a lot of them miss, or a lot of them actually not put a focus on this. Why is it important for marketers to understand the role of AI and DM? In traditional way, marketing, or even in traditional digital marketing, like 10 years back, what we used to do is, let me go and learn what are the optimizations that I can do. So you go and learn about every type of optimization. If I change the bid, what will happen? If I do a budget changes, what day of the day I should do, what rule I create. A lot of optimizations that we get into, a lot of manual work that we get into. We need to slightly move away from that kind of behavior to an understanding AI in digital marketing. Why it is important? It is very simple. Because these computer programs uses various signals, which I mentioned multiple times in the presentation. It uses signals like your conversion data, your purchase data, etc., to understand the right audience. And it understands the creative mix, it understands the placements, bids, budgets, demographic. It uses these signals and many other signals to reach the right user. So for example, if you take the creative mix, if you use a CPA like an install now, and if you use a offer creative, try and reach out to the people who are likely to click on an offer creative, because it has already a data. When you run an offer, what kind of users who already has yet to run a content like this, you try and show to them. When you use a higher budget in the day, it's try and push it to a video platform, because you are telling, I want to spend this money. What does it do? It looks at the platform where a lot of audience are sitting, and it try and push the budget there. So we need to understand how this AI and machine learning are working in the backend. It comes with experience. So whenever you make changes, it behaves in a certain way, and learn from that. And every learning is important in that, and then basis that learning, plan your next campaigns, because we need to learn. Without learning, it doesn't happen. So what I'm trying to say end of the day is, one of the main and important source of information is also, so before going to that, what I'm trying to say, end of the day is, understand these behaviors of these systems, which how does that machine learning and algorithms work in the backend, and then you optimize the campaign or set your bids or budgets accordingly. Otherwise, what happens is, like I mentioned earlier, today you kept a 10,000 rupees budget, and tomorrow you're keeping as a 50,000. Systems are so confused, doesn't know what to do. It might spend, but not get on the result, right? So ideally, you'll say, I'll put a 10,000 budget today and give some time, and then slowly increase to 20,000 and slowly increase to 50,000. So that way, you are reaching a scale, at the same time you are bringing the efficiency. So this comes with an experience. You need to understand in depth of how this AM and ML, AI and ML works, and that is where the role of human here, human expertise come here. You understand this and then give the input to the system rightly, and rest of the system will take care of it. To end with, one of the main and important sources of information, as I mentioned earlier, it is the data lies with us. If you are a brand, the data is with you. Feed the systems with the right input, like a goal, bid, budget, conversion actions, like installs, event, sign up, purchases, etc., to drive the maximum results out of this campaign.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Manipal ProLearn, everybody. Thank you so much, and I hope these presentation helped you a lot. You can always reach out to the ProLearn team and for more queries, things like that. And also, you can reach out to me at my LinkedIn at Gokuldas K. Thank you so much, and thank you, Manipal team, for arranging this session and webinar.
Hey, thanks for watching. Do like the video and share it, and also don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such videos. And check out the exclusive coupon codes for our YouTube learners in the description below. And visit ManipalProLearn.com to redeem them.